Hi, I'm Wingley Times editor Richard Lee, and behind the lens is my pal Terry Knight. And we're here at a very special venue, Wycombe Lakes near Scarborough. Now, at 7.5 acres, it might not look much, but let me tell you this, it's a very, very special water indeed. Just a few weeks ago, it produced a fish, a pike, of £45, 14 ounces. Now, that's just 1 meal away from becoming a British record. Let's go and try and catch it.
I am at the moment got the shakes because we did see the big fish come up and take the bait. I haven't rushed it because I don't want to lose it. So I'm going to have a go.
Is the bait, is it all right? Yeah.
Lying down now, I'm going to strike it.
Go on then.
Oh, it's a big fish. Oh, it's a big fish. It is a very big fish. Rich, would you please?
Yeah, I'll have to stop filming. Sorry, guys.
Oh!
Oh no!
It's come off.
Oh no!
It's come off.
Look at the swirl behind. Look at the swirl behind. Oh my!
It's come off. Oh dear. Have I blown my chance? Have I blown my chance? Please take it again. Please, please take it again.
Do you ever get that sinking feeling, Terry, when hours after a take and you've lost the British record, that it may never happen again?
I had that sinking feeling as soon as I knew the fish wasn't on any longer and my rod tip bounced up.
There's trout all around, isn't there?
All around us, we're just, I mean, we're sitting here now, we're just hoping that the big girl comes back in and has another go. Big girl like that needs to eat more than one bait a day like that. Yeah.
So if you're a betting man, what with your own money, what would you wager of your own money, your chance you'll ever get another chance like that?
Well, I've still got a chance yet. Still got a chance yet. I'm not giving up until we go home tomorrow afternoon. At that time, chances are it'll never ever happen again.
Just how big could that fish have been? If you think about the fact that it could have eaten and it's carrying spawn.
Well, it was so close to the record a couple of weeks ago. It's only got to eat a couple of trout in a couple of weeks and it's up there again. You know, it's up there possibly above what it was. Well, my view, it would probably be a pound or two heavier. I mean, when you sit here and you look at the amount of fish that are swimming around here, trout, and the big girl's been coming in chomping at them, it's inevitable, it's got to put weight on.
And the spawn, 2 weeks.
And the spawn as well, of course. Yeah. Can we stop talking about it now?
Okay, so day two, we've had a lot of disappointment last night. You start to realise, after a few hours, you know, over a beer, just what you lost, you know, the day before. And the size of the fish. I mean, this is a fish of a lifetime, and truly incredible. So you turn up next day, and I didn't really give as much chance, to be honest. I thought if the fish was pricked, it probably wouldn't want to feed again for some time. But we headed back to the same spot and figured that this fish was coming in to look at the trout that had come around the trout cage. There was an awful lot of trout out there, and we felt maybe if we could go there to leave the baits close to the cage, it might, and it was a long shot, it might just come back. And guess what? Unbelievable. Enjoy this. Okay, so we launched the boat and I've manoeuvred us right down to the bottom, probably an area that's about 15 foot, shallow into 8 foot. and I've tied the boat off against the trout pen. Now, this looks a promising area because it's certainly a zone that produced the fish in the past. And I'd say it's got a nice feature. And we were only here 15 minutes when this happened. Take a look.
Something very big.
It's something very big. What's that? No rod there, no rod.
It's big.
There's only one up at me. Only one up at me. So don't make any mistake.
Well done.
Yes!
Hold it. Just hold it. Hold it. Hold it.
I've got it.
I can't get my breath. I mean, we've persevered. We've brought the baits in right close to the bait.
Boat.
Yeah. Boat, sorry. Hoping that the pike was sitting out there and coming in and feeding on the trout around the cage. It took it off gently. It walked, it moved away at a nice pace. Rich kept telling me it was a trout. I kept asking him, what do we do? And he said, treat it as a pike, a stroke. And it's in the bloody net! Yes! Man, look at that.
That's just an immense creature.
Just, what is it going to be? What
well,
is
that's
it gonna
the question,
weigh?
Isn't it? What's she going to be?
What?
Is she more or is she less?
More or less the same, who knows? It's just an incredibly... Look at the size of it in the net. The back on it, Terry.
I know. I've just told Steve-o.
Have you?
Just told him to phone the lads, Terry. Can hear me some bits. He can't believe it, can he?
He had tears coming.
He's blubbing again. He blubbed in Ireland, he's blubbing again.
You ready?
Yep.
You're just feeling my in. My hand's on the hook.
You ready?
Yep. It's lost loads.
Taz?
Taz, it's lost loads away.
£3. She's perhaps spawned then?
43.
She might have lost it with...
Nine.
Perhaps spawn.
Might have lost it with being caught a couple of times.
I think it's 13.
It's possible.
43, 13.
What do you think about that, Terry?
What do I think about this? As 50 years wait for this.
What's it weigh? 40?
43, 12, I think somebody said. I'll get to confirm that in a minute.
What a fish.
Absolutely heaven. 50 years in search of a fish like this.
You got there. Right, let's get her back.
I got there.
Let's get her back.
She's a beauty, isn't she?
Yeah. Well, what can I say? Today I achieved a lifetime's ambition, and after the performance of yesterday of losing that possibility of that lifetime ambition, obviously today was utopia. We managed to get the fish out. A second chance is unbelievable. But, you know, I owe a lot of this, achieving that lifetime's ambition, to Richard Lee and to Wycombe Lakes and the owner, Mike. Because without their help and the opportunity to get on for fish, to fish for fish like this, and chances are I'll never get another one. So I'm in cloud nine and I'm having a big fat cigar to celebrate.